Well, it's certainly inadequate, but it's not just a failing of the president. It's particularly a failing of Democrats and Nancy Pelosi, because if they did the work that we send them to Washington to do, it wouldn't be falling to our criminal jackass president to construct in an executive order what Congress should have passed in legislation 3 months ago, 5 months ago. There were several bills that passed in the wake of the pandemic, and those measures prioritized issues from giving tax breaks to millionaires, which Nancy Pelosi approved, before canceling rents and mortgages. They included an expansion of paid sick leave to cover only 20% of the workforce, leaving 80% of the workforce in the unfortunate position of having to go to work or letting their families be hungry. And that's a really bad policy in the middle of a pandemic. And of course, you know, corporate Democrats haven't showed up at any point for the Medicare for All solution, which would ensure that cost would no longer be a barrier to care. And I've often said that that was a brutal and vicious commitment before the pandemic. In the middle of a global pandemic, to deny anyone care because of cost, while recognizing that their health impacts everyone else's, it is senseless to the point of stupidity. And that's our national policy, with the support of corporate Democrats, including Nancy Pelosi.
Listen to the full show at This Is Revolution Podcast. Find us at Spotify, Podbean, SoundCloud, Apple Podcasts, and wherever else you get your podcasts. This is Revolution.